You get butterflies in your stomach. What is it that a nigga is to do? Okay, so here we go. Let me address this man's issue. You get butterflies in your stomach when you talk about this girl, when this girl is brought up. Here's what you do, bro. You have to remember, well, I mean, it's natural to get nervous. I mean, that's not like uncommon. I mean, you're going to get nervous when you talk to the person that you're interested in. You have to make sure that you, okay, here's another thing, right? Don't suck her dick. Make it so you have fun. You play around, but at the end of the day, you're still like nice to her. Like, I mean, like, this is an interaction technique that applies to everyone. Male, female, associate, best friend, no matter who it is, workplace environment or whatever, there is always, always, never one or the other. It's always a combination of both to certain degrees, a degree of push and a degree of pull. I wish somebody taught me what I'm about to tell you when I was younger. I don't talk about this in regular streams because it just feels as if the knowledge will go wasted on some people. Some people don't acknowledge this. Do you know what nice guy syndrome is? It's people that use too much pull and not enough push. This doesn't just apply to getting with a chick. It doesn't just apply to, you know, sleeping with a chick one night. I mean, you could use it for those things. A girl could use it to get with a guy really quick. I mean, guys with girls, girls with guys. But I mean, at the end of the day here, where it truly matters is interactions with regular individuals, human beings that you meet on a regular basis. This is something that I learned myself, and I use it every day. I mean, not to the benefit of being able to get closer to people, but I find it fun too. Degrees of interaction with other human beings, and this is not something I would ever say in a regular live stream, but interacting with another human being involves a certain degree of push. You don't just appeal to their desires to make them feel comfortable and you bring them in. No. What happened? Have you guys ever had it where someone complimented you and you felt like, oh, stop it. Oh, you know, you're being too nice. Or, oh, you know, that feeling doesn't just come from being humble. That's actual pressure, anxiety, tension built up from the expectations of the individual giving you said compliments because there's no relief. They just continue to lay on the compliments, continue to make you feel special, encourage you, compliment you to the point where you feel awkward. Don't you feel awkward when someone compliments you too much? Not necessarily speaking to the nature of that person, but because it's like, you know, oh, you know, I'm not that special, you know, chill. I'm not trying to like come out here, feel like a celebrity. Every time someone compliments you, it builds up pressure. Depending on the nature of the compliment, it builds it up a little bit more or a little bit less. But the point is that it builds pressure, expectation, tension. If you have somebody who comes up to you, how many times have you had it? Somebody comes up to you on the street and they're like, yo, oh yeah, listen, man, I want to talk to you. You look like such a great individual. I really want to break it down to you, my situation, because you look like someone that will listen to me. Here in New York City, homeless people come up to you on a regular basis and they consistently butter you up. Give you compliments, pressure you to give them something. And that's the thing. Doesn't it make you say, okay, what do you want from me? You keep building up all these expectations. You keep complimenting me. You keep giving me all these things that make me feel like I'm a good person. What do you want? The pressure from those interactions is built up. And this is something that everybody should teach their children, I feel, because it would help them to all that pressure being built up from compliments and over the top, like condolences. I mean, it builds it to a point where it's awkward. Because if you're with somebody who compliments you to the point where you're like, okay, you know, like it's really not that serious, you feel like I need to back away from you. Like, it's like, okay, chill, nigga. Like, I'm not, what do you want from me? Why are you doing all this? Like, you know, you're saying all this shit. And this is the nice guy syndrome. This is the field that a lot of guys fall into. If they meet a girl, they're like, oh, you're so beautiful. I can't get over how stunning you look. Your outfit's amazing. I love your makeup. Your dress is outstanding. And it's just like, the girls are like, okay, are you like, how, like, are you a fucking rapist? I mean, they don't think, I mean, I'm just judging ahead of time. But, you know, a lot of the time, they're just like, yo, chill, nigga, like, fuck. I'm going to tell you guys now exactly what you need to know, in my personal opinion, which will help you out. All that pressure that's built, it's all about push and pull. Whether it be a little bit of push and a ton of pull, or a little bit of pull and a ton of push. every human interaction that you have, whether it be with a significant other, a person of the opposite gender, or a person of the same gender, anyone you meet in life, the key to establishing a solid relationship with that human being, any human you meet, is a good balance of push and pull. You need to make sure that while you let them know that you're interested in establishing some sort of interaction with them, a pull, that you're also willing to have fun, joke around, and play games. A push. Once you master the art of push and pull, your interactions will get far better, whether it be on the platonic level or the actual intimate level. And I have a lot of references I can use for this, but the main thing to understand is that some people require a little bit of push and a ton of pull, where, you know, you joke around, you make light laughter, banter on a small level, and you pull a ton. Or the opposite, you make a ton of jokes, you clown them, you bullshit, and then you have a little bit of pull. It depends on who you're talking to. Obviously, you know, there's a bunch of human beings out there. You have to change up your approach depending on who you're interacting with. But I mean, always go in there with at least a little bit of 50-50. As you see how their personality is, a lot of guys that I've met, you know, sometimes they like a lot of pull and a little bit of push. Sometimes they like a lot of push and a little bit of pull. It depends. But you can never, never, ever go in 100% pull or 100% push. I've explained what pull is. Compliments, buttering them up, making them feel nice, encouragement, personality boost, you know, stuff to make them say, oh, stop it. You know, you need to, I'm not that special or whatever. That's the pull. What's a push? They give you you give a bunch of compliments, you give a bunch of stuff, and then you're like, wait a minute, it's dark in here. I don't see anything. You could be ugly as fuck for all I care. That's a fucking push. That's the push. When you make a joke, because the thing is, the pressure that's built up from constant compliments and constant pull, the pressure that's built from that, when you tell a good joke, it relieves every single amount of that pressure. So no longer are you working with like, oh, are you a fucking weirdo trying to like, you know, take advantage of me? No, you work with this guy's he's a funny guy. He's a comedy artist. He's a fucking idiot. He's a stupid ass. And that relieves all of that pressure. You have to learn how to be good at jokes to utilize the push-pull method. Whether it be an associate at work, someone you're trying to establish a better connection with when it comes to getting things done, or whether it be a romantic interest, you have to get the hang of push-pull. You have to understand whether the person you're interacting with likes a lot of push or a lot of pull. How many times has it been that we've interacted with someone and it seems like they cut ass on each other? They make huge jokes on each other just for the benefit of, you know, making fun. But that's not the way it works. Deep down, you may not see it, but there's actually pull involved in that. They let each other know in very subtle ways, you're a cool person. I'm interested in you. I like you. I like spending time around you. But they use push to emphasize that. It's a little bit weird. I don't know if all of you guys understand. I got to use the bathroom. I got to piss. I've been drinking a lot of alcohol. Give me a second.